in a transparent and democratic election, praised by the world, voted for a party which Britain and America and Israel don't like. That's the reason the siege was imposed. Was imposed the day after that election result, when it became clear that the people who had won the policy of the people they had defeated in that election. I want to make it clear, because it's the honest truth. I have never been a supporter of Hamas. I was with Arafat from the age, my age, of 21 years old, and was with him at his bedside in the Percy Military Hospital in Paris when he passed away. I have never accepted that anyone is entitled to choose the Palestinian leadership except the Palestinian people themselves. I didn't accept the right of others to deselect Arafat, and I don't accept the right of others to de-elect Hamas either. But here's the uncomfortable truth. The siege on Gaza is not just an Israeli siege. It's not just an Israeli and American siege. It's not just an Israeli and American and European siege. It's an Arab siege as well. That's the truth. You saw all those people on that video locked out of the gates of Gaza. Why? Why are the gates from one Arab country to another Arab country locked at all? Indeed, why are there gates at all? That's the question we have to ask. You saw His Excellency, the former governor of North Sinai, say with a straight face on the video that the convoy is allowed to enter Gaza for a full, he emphasized, a full 24 hours. Why 24 hours? Why should one Arab country tell hundreds of people who came all the way from America to give medicine to another Arab people under siege? Why should they be allowed just a full 24 hours and not as long as they would like to stay in that Arab country? And here I want to address